In this video, I'm going to analyze the stock of both Home Depot and Lowe's and try and figure out which one is a better deal based on their profitability, their balance sheets, and some other metrics, and using an intrinsic valuation analysis. So hey, if you're new to the channel, my name is Dan. I'm a business school professor interested in accounting and finance. So if you're into investing, if you're into saving, hit that subscribe button to check out more videos like this one. All right, let's get started. Okay, so as far as how these two companies make their money, it's very similar. They're both home improvement retailers. They're pretty well diversified, as you can see from this chart here. For Home Depot, they don't rely on really any single category that much to make their money. Let's compare that to Lowe's over here. Pretty similar picture emerging. Lowe's is slightly more dependent on a few categories, with 14% of revenues coming from their appliances and 13% from lumber and building materials. But overall, they're really not reliant on any individual product category. Okay, so let's compare the two companies' balance sheets. One thing I really don't love is that both companies have a very high liabilities to assets ratio. It's really not significantly different between the two of them, but it is pretty darn high, close to 100% there. That's some high leverage. As far as the liquidity goes, they are retailers. You're going to see low liquidity ratios, but they have a pretty respectable current ratio, which is really the important thing when you're looking at a retailer with fast moving inventory. You're less concerned with that quick ratio being below one. Interest coverage ratio, very interestingly, Home Depot's is quite a bit higher than Lowe's there. So I got to give the nod to Home Depot for a little more safety there, a little better solvency. They both have a similar amount of cash on their balance sheets as a percentage of their total assets. And they both have a similar amount of long-term assets. Okay, let's compare the profitability of both companies. One thing to note for Home Depot, they got negative return on equity for these two most recent periods. I would just assume that was positive. The reason I say that is it's kind of an anomaly just because they had negative equity in those years as a result of buying so many of their shares back. There's a lot of detail to it. It's kind of an accounting thing, but don't get tripped up by it. Just assume these are positive numbers here. And so when I look at both companies, they both have extremely good return on equity there. And, you know, with Home Depot being a little bit better there, coming in at 400% compared to 272% for Lowe's. In terms of margins, you got Home Depot averaging, you know, I'd say 9% margins, somewhat trending upward over the past 5 years. Compare that to Lowe's. Lowe's has significantly worse margins, although they are trending upward so that they have a lot of room for improvement. Asset turnover, okay, pretty similar. Home Depot is a little better though, coming in at a pretty consistent 2.4-ish. Compared to Lowe's there, who averages around 2, I would say, 2.1. So in terms of profitability, Home Depot the winner there. So here is dividend and share buyback data for Home Depot. As you can see, they have a nice streak of increasing their dividend. It's an excellent dividend growth investment. And in the red here, you have share buybacks. So they've spent quite a bit on share buybacks, sometimes more money than the dividend itself. And as they have fewer shares, that allows them to pay even higher dividends going forward. Let's compare that to Lowe's, and you can see a bit of a different strategy. While Lowe's has increased their dividend every year for about 50 years or so, they've done so while recently pumping more money into share buybacks. So it's a bit of a slower dividend growth, but a much more secure dividend, as their number of shares has gone down pretty dramatically in the past 5 years. And here are payout ratios for Home Depot. As you can see in the blue here, they usually don't pay out any more than 20% of their profits as a dividend, leaving them plenty of room for reinvestment to open new stores But mostly they've really taken a lot of that money and done share buybacks, especially in the last 2 years. As you can see here in green, their modified payout ratio. So that's getting close to 100% there. This company is really a cash cow. You see really a similar picture here at Lowe's, although they went pretty bananas a few years back, really buying back tons of their own shares there in 2019, with the modified payout ratio getting to be about 200%. So that really leveraged them up, and that's going to be a burden on them, that leverage. But as far as the number of shares, they've really reduced them, and that allows them to increase dividends. Okay, so both companies are very impressive, super profitable, you know, okay balance sheets, really not great, but okay. And so I'd be interested to invest in either company. The only thing is, can I make money doing so? And that's always the question with investing. To get at that, I'm going to use the free cash flow to equity model. Both companies don't pay a high enough dividend for me to really use the dividend discount model. They take a lot of their profits and plow it back into the business, really just buying a lot of shares back with it lately. So anyhow, to make the model work, I'm going to estimate next year's free cash flow to equity. That's fairly straightforward. We have analyst estimates, tons of analysts following these two companies. I'm then going to estimate how much that can grow over the next 5 years. Afterward, I need to estimate some kind of perpetual growth rate they can grow at forever. I'll just say about 1.5% for that one. And for the next 5 years, how much are they going to grow? It depends on which company. I'm going to look at the analyst forecast for each company and come up with about the average. But I will show you the value under different growth rates for both companies so you can assess yourself. Now, as far as discount rates, I think they're both, you know, riskier balance sheet companies. Yet, I have to say they're both very established. I don't expect them to go anywhere. They have pretty low default risk in that respect. So I think about a 7% discount rate would be about fair if you ask me. Some people would choose 8%. All right, so here's a valuation matrix for Home Depot. Each cell is the theoretical fair price for Home Depot, assuming a given discount rate and a given growth rate in their free cash flow to equity over the next 5 years. Afterwards, we assume a 1.5% growth in free cash flow forever. So if we do this type of analysis, what we find here, if I use a 7% discount rate, is that a lot of these values are less than the stock price today. So for example, 7% discount rate, 8% growth in free cash flows, the stock would be worth about $241 today. That is less than what it's trading for, and to me, that's the most likely sell based on analyst forecast and everything. So for me, it doesn't look like a great deal. But I showed you all the sales. You can make your own judgment. I mean, look, another way of looking at this whole thing is to say the following. Okay, I want a 6% return on my investment, and I think Home Depot is going to grow at 8%. So they're worth $301.48. That's another way of looking at it. And so if you want a low risk, low return type of investment, this does seem to fit the bill. You can get more insight when we look at the matrix below, which shows you the discount or premium you're paying compared to the intrinsic value under all the assumptions. So given the share price of about $275 today, it looks to be overvalued under a wide variety of assumptions. Really only makes sense if you're going for that lower return, lower risk. Let's compare to Lowe's. Now, because of analyst forecasts are so much higher, I'm putting anywhere from 10 to 13% expected growth in free cash flow to equity. I think Lowe's also needs at least a 7% discount rate. Based on the forecast, I think this sell right here is the most likely, $164.18 per share. Unfortunately, the stock is currently trading at about 171, making this slightly overvalued. In fact, in most sales, it's overvalued. If you look at the matrix below here, you can see it's mostly in red. It's only undervalued if you're using a 6% discount rate. So again, if you want a lower risk, lower return stock, Lowe's definitely fits your bill. And if you compare the two, it's certainly a better deal than Home Depot. Can we learn anything from those insiders, the executives, the board of directors? Well, when we look at their trading activity in the most recent 3-month period, for Home Depot, you got 5 people buying, 8 selling. When we examine the number of shares involved, you're looking at, you know, quite a significant amount more shares sold than shares bought, close to a 7-to-1 ratio there for Home Depot. Not a great signal. Let's look at Lowe's here. You got almost no activity in the past 3 months. Now, they were loading up in the most recent 12-month period. You had 13 buys and 4 sells. When you look at the number of shares involved, basically no one has traded in the past 3 months. 410 shares sold, very low volume. About 2-to-1 ratio there in the most recent 12-month period. But again, the stock has moved up quite a bit recently. And so, you know, this signal is a bit too old here. I like to look at the most recent 3-month period. And for Lowe's, there's really no information there. Nobody buying or selling. All right, guys, here are my final thoughts on Home Depot and Lowe's. Both are really excellent retailers to own, which is a really hard thing to find these days. You've got so many retailers out of business or filing for bankruptcy right now as we speak. And so it's really great to have these companies that have really thrived even during the pandemic. That being said, you got to get a good price. And when I look at the prices right now, they're pretty darn high. You know, even plugging in some pretty healthy growth rates for Lowe's, you don't really see that good of a deal for either company. It really can't be that bad of a deal either when you've got companies like this. But it's going to be kind of a Procter & Gamble, kind of a Walmart stock at these prices. What I mean by that is it's going to be low returns, low risk. And that's fine if that's what you want to do. I mean, quite a few people are concerned the stock market is very high right now, but they don't want to have their money on the sidelines because of inflation concerns. They want to put their money in something, and bonds aren't paying anything. So there are people that are interested in these very safe, low return stocks, like a Walmart, like a Lowe's, or like a Home Depot. If that's what you want to do, I would lean more towards Lowe's at the prices right now. Lowe's looks to be a better deal. And so if you use a 6% discount rate, Lowe's can actually be undervalued by close to 20%. So for me, Lowe's is the winner. That's just my opinion. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Thank you.